Have you wondered how it would be to use an old budget device in 2020? Hey guys, this is AMRS and welcome to my video. Samsung released this budget phone on April of 2013 at a price of 15,000 rupees. And here are the device specs. I used this phone throughout my high school and the start of my college years, and honestly, it did everything I wanted it to do. Having a headphone jack is exotic nowadays, but it's hard to find a micro USB around you, as all phones have shifted to USB-C except one specific brand, which we all know. The only reason that made me upgrade to a new phone was its lack of software support, but I have solved that issue to some extent. LineageOS runs pretty smoothly on this device, but it does stutter occasionally in some apps due to its old hardware. YouTube videos play smoothly, but it has two problems. One, the 4.7-inch TFT LCD display of 199 ppi only supports a maximum resolution of 480p and has terrible viewing angles. Two, as it only supports 3G, streaming videos through Wi-Fi is probably better. Now coming to music, Spotify runs exceptionally well, but I prefer using an earphone for a better experience. The phone sports a single back-mounted speaker, so while watching videos, it wouldn't get muffled by our hand, but it might get muffled if you keep it on your bed. Scrolling on Instagram is pretty good, and it makes the time run really fast. While browsing on Chrome is honestly really painful, mainly for two reasons. Reason one being that Chrome hogs all your phone resources, and reason two, this phone doesn't have much resources for Chrome to hog on. This clip has been sped up 4 times, and you can see how slow it's on this device. Texting on this device is a breeze, as LineageOS has Google Keyboard, which is my favorite keyboard, preloaded as default. Calls work as expected, but does not support voice over LTE as in today's devices. Dark mode is not natively supported in Android 6, but most apps have dark mode available within the app. LineageOS provides some theming options as well, where everything from boot animations to app icons can be customized to your liking. Light photo editing on Lightroom works perfectly with no lags. Google Assistant also works really well. Now moving to gaming, some games works fine while some stutters a lot. Candy Crush Saga feels right at home with no lags at all, while Subway Surfers lags a lot to a point where the game is not playable, as you can see how laggy the experience is. Hill Climb Racing works the best and the gameplay is enjoyable. Smash Hit does stutter occasionally and some frame drops can be seen. Fruit Ninja works really fine. I tried to install Asphalt 8. I did manage to get Asphalt Nitro instead. I think it's fine, I guess. And PUBG is incompatible due to hardware limitations. The inbuilt camera app works fine, but I couldn't get the video to work. The video recording freezes and never gets saved. Anyway, here's a few photo samples compared with S7 Edge. I get a screen on time of 3 hours with my usage. Battery on this device is still factory and hasn't been replaced, so we'll have to consider its degradation too. In a time where all phones have non-removable batteries, this one gives us nostalgia. There are a few drawbacks of such an old hardware, even though its software is much newer. The 1GB RAM is not enough to run apps in 2020. The screen is in Corning Gorilla Glass, but it's a type of tempered glass and has only a few light scratches. But the sides of the phone didn't stand the course of time well, as it's got a few dings here and there. Also, after installing all the social media apps and games, there isn't much storage left, as it's only 8GB. Should you use a phone this old? That would be a no from me. But honestly, this was a fun project. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please like and subscribe if you haven't.